All things Mavs.
Mavs fans, what's going on? Welcome into All Things Mavs, coming to you straight off the W over the Philadelphia 76ers. The Dallas Mavericks win a freaking overtime game in scrimmage play. That's right, we all stayed up late. It's about 10 p.m. here on a Tuesday night in Dallas, and the Dallas Mavericks defeat the Philadelphia 76ers in their final scrimmage, 118-115. Overtime drama in the final game of scrimmage play. The Mavs go 2-1 in their three scrimmage games. And you know what that means, ladies and gentlemen? Basketball is back on Friday night. The Mavs and the Houston Rockets go at it at, I believe, 7:30 p.m. or 8 o'clock p.m. I'm not sure. I don't have the schedule right in front of me, but that is going to be a fun one. So today on the podcast, I want to break down the Mavs 118-115 win over the Philadelphia 76ers. Tell you who impressed, a.k.a. Antonius Cleveland. I'm going to tell you, you know, what I noticed that the Mavs should kind of look to work on before they get the regular season going. And, you know, just talk some basketball with you guys. And really excited. You know, I love doing these post-game podcasts. It's been a lot of fun to be able to sit down and record them after the game and just kind of bring a new personality, new engagement opportunity on Chat Sports and on the All Things Mavs channel. So continue to subscribe. I'm your host, Jimmy Crowther. I'll be with you all season long, all off season long, and hopefully for a long time coming here on All Things Mavs. And I want to do something special. So of course, we're going to break down the win. I'm going to give you the box score. I'm going to give you all the stats, but I want to do something really special here for the Mavs fans listening. The first person to go into the comment section of this video on YouTube and predict the correct score and the correct winner of the Houston Rockets-Dallas Maverick game in the comment section will receive $10 via Venmo from me personally. So, like, I know it's not going to change your life, but 10 bucks, that's a meal. So, you scroll down, you go ahead and put that in the comment section, the correct score, the correct winner. And there's only going to be one, so if only one person can get the correct answer. If you do that and you get it right for the Houston Rockets-Dallas Mavericks game on Friday, I'll Venmo you 10 bucks. So go do that in the comment section. And now we will get into the box score of the Dallas Mavericks versus Philadelphia 76ers scrimmage game from Tuesday night. Now, Luka Doncic led the way with 23 points. He went 9 of 16 from the field, also pulled down 7 rebounds, dished out 6 assists. He had 3 turnovers, went 1 of 5 from 3. I'll talk about him here more in a minute. Kristaps Porzingis, 17 points and 12 rebounds. He got the, as Mark Fellowa likes to call it, the bubble double there for the Dallas Mavericks against the 76ers. He played 26 minutes, of course, coming off that game that he missed against the Indiana Pacers. Antonius Cleveland, the story of the night. He had, let's look at it, 14 points on 5 of 8 shooting. He also pulled down 4 rebounds, had an assist, had a block, and he was plus 10 in the game tonight. JJ Barea, 14 points, 5 of 9 shooting, 2 of 5 from the field, 2 of 2 from the free throw line, also had 3 assists and 2 rebounds. Tim Hardaway Jr. in 26 minutes had 10 points on 3 of 8 shooting. He also pulled down 5 rebounds. Trey Burke got his first minutes in the NBA bubble and scored 9 points, 3 of 8 shooting, knocking off some rust there. 3 of 3 from the free throw line, dished out 3 assists, and was a minus 3 in the box score. Josh Reaves, the Reaves Hive, tied with Boban Marjanovic for the least amount of minutes played, had only 8 minutes, but made the most of those 8 minutes and scored 7 points on 3 of 5 shooting, knocked down a 3-pointer off a dish from JJ Barea, and had 1 rebound. Dorian Finney-Smith had 25 minutes. He only scored 5 points, but he did end up pulling down 4 rebounds, 2 offensive, 2 defensive, 2 assists, and had a steal in the game. Justin Jackson, man, you guys know how much I love me some Justin Jackson. Not so much tonight. 26 minutes, 5 points, 2 of 6 from the field, 0 of 1 from 3, 1 of 2 from the free throw line. He did have 4 rebounds and 2 assists, also had 2 turnovers, 2 steals, and was a plus 3 in the box score with 4 fouls. Seth Curry, not a great game. He's had 2 kind of inconsistent games after that opener against the Los Angeles Lakers. He had 5 points on just 1 of 6 shooting from beyond the 3-point arc, 2 rebounds, an assist, and a turnover for Seth Curry tonight. DeLon Wright, again, kind of disappointing night for DeLon. I didn't love what I saw out of him. Didn't love what I saw. Didn't love what I see. And, you know, proper grammar is harder than it looks, all right? 18 minutes, 4 points, 2 of 8 shooting for DeLon Wright. He did have 5 rebounds, which was pretty good, a steal and a block as well, minus 1 in the box score. Boban Marjanovic, 8 minutes, didn't play a whole lot in this game because there weren't a lot of big men out there for the Philadelphia 76ers, but he had 3 points and 6 rebounds in those 8 minutes. Maxi Kleba, meanwhile, 15 minutes and 2 points, 3 rebounds, 0 of 2 from 3, minus 2 in the box score, but he did have 2 assists. The only Maverick that did not play tonight was, again, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And Rick Carlisle said something about, you know, physically, he's just not there yet. He's just not ready, which I didn't understand. It made it sound like he's dealing with an injury, which is a bit curious because we haven't heard anything about him actually being injured. We've just seen him missing practices and missing time for personal stuff, but no MKG in this game. It's weird, and to be honest, I don't expect him to play that much in the regular season. I think Antonius Cleveland is going to steal his minutes, and I'll talk about him here more in a minute because he was super, super impressive tonight, but no MKG, so that's your real only news from this game. You know, everybody stayed healthy. Luka Doncic early in the game had a couple moments where thought he had a little tweak, but it's just Luka being Luka, and he was totally fine. But, you know, I guess no news is good news on this one for the Dallas Mavericks. And now we're going to get into some winners, some losers, and what I liked and what I didn't like so much about this game because there was a lot on both sides. All right, let's talk about the most impressive Mavericks from tonight. Antonius Cleveland. That's where I'm going to start because he came in, he played 17 minutes, he scored 14 points. This is the second night in a row that I have seen stuff from Antonius Cleveland that I really liked. And it wasn't just three-point shooting this time because last game he was knocking down some three-pointers in the corner. No, this time he was scoring from all over the field, all over the court. 2 of 4 from three, but he also got a ton of nice shots at the rim. One thing that he's always done really well since the summer league is be able to score on the fast break, and he did that tonight. It was really, really nice. He played some strong defense, and he showed that, you know, he is 26 years old, but he could break into the rotation next season. I really do think he could. Now, this year, you know, I do think he takes Michael Kidd-Gilchrist's minutes because MKG isn't healthy. We don't know what he is right now. We know what Antonius Cleveland is. He's a consistent shooter. He can finish around the rim, and he's going to play strong defense. Also, he can jump out of the gym, man. This dude has got hops. I am excited about what Antonius Cleveland is. You know, he's just a two-way guy. I'm not going to overhype it. He was also playing against all the backups for the Philadelphia 76ers. But when you look at the guys Philly was playing compared to who the Mavs were playing at the end of the bench, you know, the Mavs had, you know, Antonius Cleveland, J.J. Barea, Josh Reaves, Trey Burke, Justin Jackson in there, where the Philadelphia 76ers had their legit second unit with Matisse Thybulle, Mike Scott, Kyle O'Quinn was playing. I guess he's not that normal. Alec Burks was playing normal minutes. So, you know, the second unit for the Sixers was normal. That was more of the third unit for the Dallas Mavericks, and Antonius Cleveland dominated it. He is the reason the Mavs won this game, him and J.J. Barea both. J.J. also had a nice game with 14 points. So really impressed from what I saw from Antonius Cleveland, and I was also impressed from what I saw from Josh Reaves, the other two-way guy, the Reaves Hive. And if you're in the comment section, Reaves Hive, type that honeybee emoji in the comment section because that is the hive that is alive with Josh Reaves. He only played 8 minutes, but in those 8 minutes, great defense, had a couple really nice dunks, had 7 points. He went 3 of 5. He has a nice 3-point stroke. I like him a lot, and he's a rookie. He's a guy that can really grow with this team. So, you know, if the two-way contracts stay the same next year, I hope it's still Josh Reaves and Antonius Cleveland, but I could see one of, if not both of those guys getting called up to the NBA full-time more so next year and kind of be Josh Reaves could be more of a Lugans Dort, think, for the Oklahoma City Thunder, who's turned into a full-time starter for them. That's what Josh Reaves could be. And so I was really excited from what I saw from both of those guys tonight, or if you're listening, you know, on Wednesday morning, then last night on Tuesday. Good, good game for both of them. And, you know, I don't think they're going to get regular minutes in the regular season when we get going again. But if need be, we know that these guys can play against quality competition like a guy like Alec Burks or like a guy like Matisse Thybulle or Mike Scott even. So impressed with both the two-way guys. Now let's talk about the duo of Kristaps Porzingis and Luka Doncic. And you guys know the drill. You hear KP, you put the unicorn emoji down in the comment section. That is how this works on this channel. You know the drill. Scroll down. Do that right now because KP had a great game. Had the great first half, I guess I should say. 17 points and he had 12 rebounds. He really showed that he was knocking off the rust. He made 2 3-pointers and both of those threes were from deep, man. I mean, this kid, I say kid, he's older than me, I guess. But this dude, it just has unlimited range. And that's really so important for this team to be able to stretch the floor that far out, because it opens the floor for Luka to get to the rim and dominate and do what he does. And Luka did it tonight. Now, Luka didn't look great tonight finishing around the rim. He missed a couple gimmies, and man, his three-point shot looked, it didn't look good. I'll say that. But he made up for it because he got to the rim and still scored 23 points, still dished out 6 assists and 7 rebounds, all in 26 minutes. And you know, on a usual night, Luka's going to be playing 30 to 32 minutes a night. Same with KP. KP's not just going to play 26 minutes, so he'll score more than 17 points. But I think the most encouraging thing about what KP did was rebound the ball really well. You know, he didn't play great defense. The Mavs as a whole didn't play great defense. I'll get to that here in just a minute. But he did rebound the ball really well, and he shot the ball really, really well. So really encouraged by both those guys being able to get some chemistry under their belt. You know, they played whenever one was on the floor, the other one was on the floor. And I was impressed with both of them. I didn't really see anything that I didn't like besides Luka's three-point shot not falling, but you know, that's Luka. You know, he has nights where he'll go 7 of 7 and hit everything, make everything he shoots. He'll have nights where he goes 0 of 5 from the three-point arc, but I'd rather see him go 0 of 5 than, you know, 0 of 1. I'd rather see him put up those three-pointers. I'd rather see him go for it, or you know, just go to the rim, because when he goes to the rim, no one's stopping him. I mean, there is little to no one in the league that can stop the guy what he does, because when he stops and when he goes and when he uses his pace and dictates the pace of the game, nobody is as good as Luka Doncic at finishing around the rim the way he does. He's so crafty with it, and he showed that tonight. He did it really well, but he can be better. I mean, I will say the hole in his game right now is a three-point shooting. His free throw shooting wasn't great. I mean, 4 of 6 isn't bad, but I would have liked to see him make all of those. KP had a lot of free throws tonight. He had 9, went 7 of 9 from the free throw line, which isn't bad. Good game for the duo to knock some rust off and be able to show that, hey, we're ready to go. We're ready to rock and roll for the regular season. And before I kind of go into what I didn't like about this game, can we talk about Luka Doncic's defense? You know, everybody talks about, oh, he's too slow. He's a little bit out of shape. He can't keep up with the main guy. No, sir. Luka was keeping up with Ben Simmons in this game. I mean, he was hands up, not fouling. He forced Ben Simmons to miss 2 layups in 1 possession. You know, he's not an all-defensive player, but his on-ball defense showed that he, you know, he's strong. He's got a very able body to defend good players. And if your best player can guard the best player on the other team, that's really important. Now, do I expect Luka to be guarding guys like Ben Simmons in the regular season? No, I don't. I think the Mavs will want to limit who he's guarding so he can do everything he can on the offensive end. However, to know that he can do that is very, very important. So a great defensive game from Luka, a great game from KP, a great first half especially. You know, I was really happy with what I saw from both of them. So 4 guys that stood out tonight again: Luka Doncic, KP, the unicorn, you know what to do. Josh Reaves, you know what to do, the B in the emoji, the B emoji in the comment section, and Antonius Cleveland. Those 4 guys made a huge difference for this team, and those 4 guys, I think, hopefully going forward, are valuable contributors. We know that 2 of them will be. The other 2, we'll have to wait and see. But now, let's talk a little bit about the guys that didn't do so hot and what the team didn't do so well as a whole. Now, the biggest thing with the Mavs tonight was that third quarter. That third quarter was so, so ugly. I'll try to pull the box score up here in just a minute and see if I can really get that full box score matchup, but I don't know if it's going to be coming up for me here. Well, anyway, the Mavs had a first quarter lead of over 10 points. They had a double-digit lead, and then they go into the second quarter, and they still have a whole little bit of a lead at the halftime, and then all of a sudden, the third quarter comes around. They get outscored 41-26 by the Philadelphia 76ers. Not a good third quarter at all, and that's always been the Mavs' problem. I mean, I feel like it's always been a problem with the Mavs, is not being able to sustain a lead after halftime, and in the regular season, man, that's not going to cut it. You got to have that third quarter mentality. You got to have that mentality that, hey, we're going into the fourth quarter, we got to be better. And really, mainly what it was there's just no defense. You know, it wasn't that the offense was bad, even though 26 points isn't great, but no defense. I mean, we made Tobias Harris and Ben Simmons just look like Kobe and Shaq out there. Same with Al Horford. Al Horford was killing us. So it was really frustrating, and I'm not sure what the problem was. Like, I can't point to one thing and say, oh, we didn't do that well. We're just kind of doing that Ole defense where we just let them go by. And it was really frustrating to see in the third quarter. However, it wasn't the whole team. You know, the starters didn't play the whole third. And another thing I want to say here, I mentioned it in the last podcast, but I'm going to mention it again in this one. The bench doesn't look great in this scrimmages, in these scrimmages. It just doesn't. And here's why. Because the bench lineup right now is some combination of Trey Burke, Maxi Kleba, Justin Jackson, you know, and Antonius Cleveland, J.J. Barea, Boban Marjanovic, right? That's your bench. And DeLon Wright as well. That's your bench. Well, none of those guys are going to be all out there without a starter on the floor. You know, if you have DeLon Wright and Maxi Kleba in there, you're also going to have a Luka Doncic or a Kristaps Porzingis or a Seth Curry or a Dorian Finney-Smith. Same with if you have Justin Jackson. Let's say you have four bench guys. Let's say you roll out a lineup of Trey Burke, DeLon Wright, Maxi Kleba, and let's just say Justin Jackson, right? You got four bench guys out there. You're going to have a starter. You're going to have a KP. You're going to have a Luka out there. So I wouldn't freak out too much about this bench. I think, again, Rick is just trying to knock off the rust. But the bench did not look good defensively tonight. I'll say that. They did not look good. They let a lot of things go. But the end of the bench guys, Antonius Cleveland and Josh Reaves, did look very solid. So something to watch for when the regular season gets going is how the unit, the second unit, holds up and how Rick Carlisle staggers those defenders or staggers those starters and those second string guys. But I'm not too worried about it. I do think it was a little worrisome tonight, but the Philadelphia 76ers were playing their main bench guys, and the Mavs were playing their end of the bench guys. So keep that in mind. Don't get too down on how we let that third quarter slip away. Let's focus more on, you know, we had a good overtime win. We had a strong win from our end of the bench guys that if we need them to step up, they can step up. So don't worry too much. I would be more encouraged from this game than anything. I think the Mavs should be encouraged because does this game matter in the grand scheme of things? Absolutely not. Does the fact that Antonius Cleveland scored 14 points matter in the grand scheme of things? Probably not. But what it does is it gives this team momentum going into the regular season. They've got a game against the Houston Rockets on Friday night in 2 nights, basically. You get three nights of sleep. Well, you get tonight, which is Tuesday night. You get Wednesday night, and then you get Thursday night. 3 nights of sleep, and then you got a game. So being able to come off of this win where you got to cheer on all your teammates and see them win an exciting game in overtime for the guys that don't get to play that much, that is important for this team. That is a huge morale booster. So I'm really excited about this win, even though it does not matter. I get that. It's a good morale booster, and it's good for the team to see. So overall, I'm pretty happy with it. You know, guys like DeLon Wright and Justin Jackson did not look good tonight. DeLon Wright was aggressive at the rim, but he wasn't finishing at the rim. So I guess that's a step in the right direction for him. But he's got some work to do, man. Didn't love what I saw out of him in all the scrimmages, really. Justin Jackson, first game that he really disappointed me. He did not look good. Justin Jackson Island took a huge hit tonight, but I think we will rebuild. I do think he's going to be an important part of the rotation. And then other than that, man, this team, it's got a deep bench. They've got to keep it going, though. They've got to be able to have starters in there with their bench guys. And I'm excited about this team. I'm excited about the damage they're going to do in the regular season. Before I get out of here, I do want to tell you one piece of news that you might have missed. Eric Gordon turned his ankle pretty severely in a game against the Boston Celtics on Tuesday night. And Mike D'Antoni says they don't know exactly what's going to happen. The x-rays were negative, so that's a good thing for sure. It didn't show any breaks, but Mike D'Antoni said he's going to be out, quote, at least a few days. So that could take him out of the Mavs game on Friday, and that could mean an extra little boost for Dallas in that game against the Houston Rockets. So, Mavs fans, I always appreciate you tuning in. Make sure you tweet at me at @all_things_Mavs. Share this podcast with your friends, and let's help grow the show. That would be a huge help to us here at Chat Sports. Make sure to reply in the comment section. Remember, first one to get that score right and predict the correct winner of the Mavs-Rockets game, $10 directly from me, Jimmy Crowther. I've been your host tonight. Whenever you're listening to this, I appreciate you guys. Love all you Mavs fans. Can't wait for the season to start on Friday. I'll see you next time.